to fame on American Idol back in 2009. Since then, Adam Lambert's been on a non-stop chart-topping ride with a Grammy nomination, two hit albums, and even as a replacement for the great Freddie Mercury and Queen. He's just released his third solo album, The Original High, and let's take a listen at his latest sensational track. I love it. Ghost Town. Tonight, Elvis is dead, and everyone's spread, and love is a satire. And now I know my heart is a ghost town. My heart is a ghost town. And please welcome to Studio 10, Adam Lambert.
Good. Look at all these wonderful people.
Yeah,
excited. You're just so famous and so good looking.
Yeah,
I don't think I can cope
sure.
with it.
Your eyelashes. I'm captivated by your eyelashes.
I'm captivated by yours. I think we're gonna fly away.
Adam, can we first of all welcome to Australia? We love you here.
Oh, thanks.
And can we take you back? It's a bit of a journey that you know you started with American Idol, and we've seen some vision before as you, that young nervous performer. Here it is. Here. Take us back to how you were feeling at that stage.
My heart was like in my throat. I was like, go. And I knew that it was a big moment because it was kind of a make or break kind of thing. And there was a lot of buildup, you know. When you go into one of these shows, you have to audition like twice or three times before you get to the judges over the course of like 2 months. Mm. So I was really anticipating this moment.
And Simon didn't initially like you, is that correct?
Yeah, he wasn't sure. He was giving me the kind of like the scowl. He was like squinting at me like, And then I just kind of stared at him for a little while. I remember the other judges were talking and I was like, and he wasn't looking away, and I was like,
What I loved about you on American Idol was you could see how much you grew, but you were also such a showman. Like, early on, you really kind of made it your own.
Oh, thanks.
With your look, with makeup, and all this sort of fabulous sort of theatrics, I think. Because, look, I mean, what a transformation from that sort of face, from that initial audition to there. It was incredible.
Yeah, it was quite a journey. I had so much fun on the show. Mm. I really did. And I learned a lot. You know, I think, you know, in the beginning, I was really nervous. And I look back on some of those performances now, and I realize that I was kind of overcompensating a little bit the first couple weeks. And then as I got into the competition, I definitely relaxed a little bit, which was nice.
Adam, we're seeing that vision now there. What massive shoes to fill with Freddie Mercury. How are you feeling stepping out onto that stage performing with Queen? But then what an extraordinary experience for you.
Yeah, I mean, I brought really big shoes.
I figured, and you love shoes.
Figured that would help. I did. I brought some, you know. But yeah, it was...
Look at your crown!
Yeah!
Oh, my God! So cool.
Yeah, we definitely weren't going for subtle with that look. Yeah.
I love that.
But that was when I really first started to pay attention to, and I saw all those posters around in the neighborhood saying, you know, Queen featuring Adam. I thought, who the hell is this guy? I mean, to be able to fill in for the guy who was probably the greatest showman of all time.
Yeah, he was amazing.
How did you
he
feel?
Was
did
absolutely
you ever
amazing.
Think, I just can't do this? Or did you think...
You know, it was a few years in the making because obviously I sang Bohemian Rhapsody on my audition for Idol and then met Brian and Roger at the finale. We sang together. And then after that, there was a couple different things that came up here and there. I went to Eastern Europe and did a gig with them. I did a couple other gigs here and there. And this tour that we did when we came down to Australia, I had been working with them for a couple of years, so I think I was finally like in a much more comfortable place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I've got to say, you nailed it.
Oh, thank you.
You really did.
Thank you. Thank you.
I never thought it was possible.
Oh, thank you.
Roger Taylor, the drummer from Queen, I love it. He calls you the Camp Elvis.
Yeah. I love that.
Yeah. Well, I mean, what do you think about that, being called the Camp Elvis?
I take it as a compliment. Yeah. I mean, because, you know, we love Elvis, and I love Elvis's iconic imagery, like his style and his look. And I guess I get some comparisons, but obviously I'm a lot crazier than Elvis was.
That suit, sorry, I have to know where you got that leopard print suit from.
Like,
that is
it was
amazing.
Made for the I think it was made for the tour.
Oh.
Yeah. I worked with a costume designer a lot. It was really fun. The crown, I worked with a stylist, and we sourced it, and we made it a little bigger because I think it was for a little junior Miss pageant thing. So we had to open that up because I got a big old head, you know.
Fantastic. Adam, we're going to take a quick break, but you're going to join us in just a moment. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back with Adam.